Just a quick introduction to this video. It's about Frances Glessner Lee. And if you want to find out more, I will leave a link in the description. I'm not going to go into it too much here. We'll just get straight into the video. But she was an amazing woman. I think the first ever female police captain. She started making these dioramas in the 1940s. So please go and do some more research. An absolutely fascinating individual. And as you will see from these pieces that she has created, really, really, really mind-boggling. Have fun, my dear viewers. Okay, I find these really quite amazing. And I have not researched what murder cases they actually represent, so I have no idea of the outcome. So I'm winging it here. So we're just going to discuss what might have actually happened in the scene. And you can maybe tell me in the comment section if you know what really happened, or just give your suggestions. I just think it's interesting to discuss. Here we see a woman or girl in a sink, or is it a bathtub? Is it a bathtub? I can't really tell. It could be a bathtub, couldn't it, by the shape of it and the taps at the top. I wonder what's happened. Has she fell in, hit her head and drowned with the water running? Or did somebody push her in and murder her first? I don't know. As I say, I have not researched the cases, so we're just going to discuss it. Yeah, on to the next one. I just find that they're incredible. Really well made. I've never even have heard of this before. I stumbled upon this by accident, and I thought I'd do a video on it. I hope you enjoy it as much as I enjoy these fantastically modeled scenes. And yes, these dollhouse dioramas remind me in many ways of Alan Wolfson's dioramas of America from earlier days. I did a video on his work, on his amazing work, some while back. I'll include a link at the end of this video and under the description. I wonder if he was inspired by these dollhouse diorama murder scenes. There's a lot of aspects in his work that remind me that they're very close attention to detail. Just fantastic. I was in communication with Alan some years back, but if he's watching, please let me know whether you were inspired by her work. Okay, this is the next scene. Here we see a walk-in wardrobe, a closet, and next to that is her living room, I'm guessing. In the living room, there seems to have been some drinking going on. There's two bottles there. One is lying on its side, the other one's still upright. Has there been some heavy drinking going on? And there lies the victim in the walk-in wardrobe with her head, which appears to be in a box. From this scene, we can't really see much. The next scene is a close-up, so... But maybe you budding detectives out there will be able to tell me what happened here. Okay, here we see the living room scene. Doesn't seem to be too much of a disturbance here. Doesn't look like there's been any intruders that have broke in. There's the two bottles there. One is lying on its side, the other one upright. There hasn't been any ransacking of her belongings. Could have just been a bit of a night in on her own, on the booze, and she got depressed. Very hard to tell from just that scene there. There's no indication of what might have happened. So on to the next scene. Okay, here we have a close-up of the scene in the closet. It becomes a bit clearer now. It appears that her throat has been slashed. We can see the knife lying near her hands. Are those binds on her wrists, or are they bracelets? Not really sure, but normally people don't cut their own throats for suicide. There are cases, I do know, there are cases where people slit their own throats, but is that the case here? Or has she been murdered? It's still hard to really ascertain exactly what's happened. And in the background there, are the drawers open? Does it look like the drawers have been opened? Maybe stuff has been stolen. As I say, I don't know what case this was representing, so I don't know what actually happened. As I say, any budding detectives out there, please let me know what happened here. It does seem to be rather suspicious, doesn't it? Okay, on to the next scene. Okay, here we have another scene, which is in the kitchen. We have the oven there with the door open. There appears to be something freshly baked, and the woman is lying dead on the floor. What has happened here? What has happened here? Very hard to tell from this scene. Just looking at it from here, I would say she has gassed herself, or she has fallen unconscious because of the gas in the room, or she knocked her head. I mean, the fridge door is open there to the left too, so yeah, it doesn't seem to be a suicide, because why would you have the fridge door open? That seems quite strange to me. But anyway, we'll have a look at the next scene and see if it becomes any clearer. Okay, this is another view of the same room. I can't see anything untoward here. Just seems to be a normal looking kitchen. Doesn't seem to be any signs of violence. So I can't tell anything. Am I missing something? Can you see anything that I've missed there? I can't see any blood anywhere. At first I thought that the little table there in the foreground with the chair, I thought that was a blood stain, but I think it seems to be the hand-painted pattern, because it appears on the top of the table as well. So there's no clues there for me. As I say, maybe I've missed something. On to the next scene. Here we see something a bit more suspicious. The edges of the door have been jammed with paper. Jammed with paper to seal them. Yeah, so if somebody was gassing themselves, that would stop the gas escaping out into the hallway or the rest of the house. But why? I mean, surely, even if you were living in a tenement, if you gassed yourself, there would be enough gas in the room anyway without having to seal the doors. Maybe I'm wrong. I just can't understand why somebody would do that, either the murderer or the suicide victim. Why would they do that? Unless, of course, they are living in a tenement with other apartments, and they want to make sure they don't get disturbed during their suicide, because if the other tenants smelt gas, then they would alert the authorities and maybe break down her door before she had finished doing what she wanted to do. But apart from that, I have no idea. Yeah, that's a strange one. Please enlighten me why that would be, because I am clueless about this one. Very strange. Okay, the next scene. Just before we go on to the next scene, this is a detail of the window in the kitchen, and this just shows Miss Glessner's fascinating attention to detail, because we can see outside of the window is the victim's washing hanging on the line. That's just fantastic. She really, really was an artist. Yeah, I don't know whether this is a clue. As I said at the start, these were aids to help detectives solve murders or suicides by looking at the scene and see if they can find any clues. So I don't know whether this is a clue or not. You know, did the murderer see that it was a female living there by her smalls hanging on the line there? There seems to be a brassiere hanging there. So I don't know if that's a clue or just part of Miss Glessner's love of detail. Okay, on to the next scene. Well, this seems to be a sort of classic suicide scene from first appearance. Yeah, there's the chair turned over that she's kicked over, and she's hanging there. So it does seem to be a classic suicide scene, but these dioramas were meant to train detectives not to let culprits get away. If there was indeed a murder, they have to figure out how he did it and why he did it. So I'm thinking this must have not just been a suicide. but what clues can we see? Are they books on the floor? I can't really see from here. Are they books? Why would there be a whole lot of books on the floor? The bookcase in the background, the door appears to be open on it as well. So I wonder what the connection is. Was the murderer looking for something? A will? Testament? Yeah. I really don't know what has happened here. I have no ideas. So, yeah, I'll show you the next image of that a bit closer. See if we can derive any clues from that, because, yeah, obviously I'm not going to make it as a detective. I'm bleeding hopeless. Oh, dear. Okay, here we see another angle. I'm still no further forward. What might have happened here? The window there in the background. Has that been broken? Has somebody gained entry through that window? There appears to be a sort of long pan lying there to the right on the floor, lopsided. That doesn't seem to be... Yeah, it seems to be have knocked over in some sort of disturbance. I don't know what those pans are called. Somebody's going to help me out there too. Yet apart from that, I can't see any clue to a murder. Yeah. So I will leave that with my Oddite detectives, and we will move on to the next scene. Okay, here we have a spectator's view of the diorama. On the right is the veranda or porch, and to the left we have the bedroom scene, a very bloody scene here with two corpses, lots of blood. Let's have a closer look and see what has happened here. Okay, here we have a closer look. Yes, there are two bodies, the female on the bed and the male on the floor. So what has happened here? We see that the chair has been turned over by the dresser, and there are bloodied footprints coming from the bathroom, which I presume is the bathroom. So what's happened here? Did the man kill his wife or girlfriend? And then did he go into the bathroom and slit his wrists or something and then stagger back into the room? Or were they murdered by somebody and the man ran to the bathroom, was killed there and then staggered back in? I don't know. Do you know? I really can't figure this one out either, other than it's a horrible scene of carnage. The door there, is that the closet or is it the door to the hallway? There appears to be something there. I don't know whether it's a dressing gown or something hanging on the back of the door. I don't know. So, yep, we'll have a look at the next scene. Okay, here we have a slightly different angle. And now I notice on the left-hand side of the bed where the man slept, there is a large blood stain. So, yeah. Could there be a clue that they were murdered and that it was possibly the murderer whose bloodied footprints appear on the carpet? Maybe he was going to the bathroom afterwards or the ensuite to clean himself up. Clean himself or herself up. Yeah, it doesn't... Did he fall off the bed afterwards? It does look like the first attack appeared on the bed when he was sleeping. So yeah, that's really open to interpretation, this scene. Here we have an aerial view. And looking at it now, I've just had an idea. Were the couple sleeping? The intruder has broke in. They have not woken up. He has shot the man or stabbed him to death. And then did he climb into bed and rape the woman, either before he killed her or after? Horrible as it sounds, but that could be the scenario. That he threw the man's corpse onto the floor, climbed into the bed, either woke her up or killed her and did something horrible. That's all I can think of. Tell me what you think. Let's move on to the next scene. Okay, here we have a very grisly murder scene, and I think it's without a doubt this is a murder scene. Here we have either a young woman or a young girl. I'm not sure of the costume of that time in the 1940s. Did women dress like that with a bow in the hair? Or is it a young girl? This is obviously a violent crime. To the left of the girl's head is a hammer, and there appears to be a knife sticking in her chest. And by the positioning of the corpse and the disarray of the clothing, it appears to have been also a rape. The blouse has been ripped open and the legs are apart. Horrible, yeah. So I don't know how this would train detectives. Maybe it's to look for certain clues. Yeah, it's really quite horrible. Oh, yeah, I can't see any clues apart from the hammer and the knife that the culprit has left behind. Doesn't seem to be any disarray in the room. There's a piano there. Was she a piano teacher? Or was she learning the piano? I don't know. I don't know about this one. I'll move on to the next image of the corpse. Yeah, here we have another angle of the corpse. And yeah, this is a horrible murder and sexual attack. Yeah, so that seems to be clear cut. Just interesting, the techniques. I wonder what Miss Glessner thought when she was reconstructing these murder scenes. What was going through her head? Must have been quite disturbing for her too. I see the material that she has used has deteriorated. Can you see the cracks? It must have been some sort of resin or early plastic she has used, and it's all cracking there and breaking up. Anyway, let's move quickly on from this horrible scene. And here we have a very comfy looking interior scene with a bit of chintz happening there. Yes, it looks like the lady, and you can see her in this scene just on the right there at the bottom of the stairwell. She was enjoying an evening in, reading the newspapers, having a couple of cigarettes, and there's a telephone too on the left. I think that's a telephone on the floor beside her table next to the comfy chair. So was she telephoning someone, and why did she go upstairs? We will never know. So let's have a look at the next scene. Well, yeah, it just appears to be a tragedy. She went upstairs, and on her return, she tripped and fell and broke her neck and possibly smashed her head open. There appears to be blood coming out and staining the stair carpet. Yeah, there's not too much more to add here, other than it seems to be a terrible accident, unless somebody out there knows exactly what actually happened in this reconstruction of the scene. Yeah, what I do find fascinating is the attention to detail again by Frances Glessner. Just have a look at the overflowing ashtray with the cigarettes. I mean, apparently she hand-rolled these cigarettes and lit the ends to make it look like they had been burnt or smoked. She was really dedicated to her art, to her work. Fantastic. Here we have another scene, a street scene here, and even though that Frances Glessner was helping the detectives, the police, with her work, I did read that she really enjoyed doing these dioramas, and I can see why. I mean, I love dioramas when they're well done, and these are fantastic, especially with the tools and materials she had at the time. Just brilliant. I mean, look at that window display there of a, yeah, what is it, a... This is obviously America, it's not England, so is it, it's a pub or a bar that sells spirits, or is it a shop that sells spirits, ale and beer? I'm thinking more of a bar, but yeah, when I first looked at this, I thought this was a boy lying on the ground, like a newspaper boy or something like that, but when we look at it from a different angle, I think it's a young man. I think she just had a boy doll to use as the figure. That's why it looks like a young boy, but I think it's supposed to be depicting a young man dead on the pavement. And let's have a look at the next angle, which will give you a better idea. Okay, here we have another angle, and we can see it is indeed a bar. We can see on the door there above the window, the glass there, it says bar. So it's a bar. Now here we can see more of an aerial view of the corpse. Now he appears to be carrying a toolbox. Why? Was he breaking in, or was he on his way to work, or on his way back from work? Or did he come out the bar drunk from after a day's work? He's had a few beers, maybe a few too many. And he has came out of the bar there, and was he attacked, or did something else happen? But when we see the next scene, and you can even see it in this scene, we can see there's a banana skin on the ground. So that would indicate that he has come out and, tripped on the banana skin, cracked his skull open, and died. But is that the case? Is that the case? Or was he murdered and the banana skin just happened to be there? I'm sure the detectives had fun with this one. Okay, my cat has just come into the room. It wants me to feed her, so on to the next scene. Here we have another diorama that she has made of a burned-out cabin. Just fantastic. She really did have an artist's eye. Just amazing. Really love it. And the lamp is still burning. There's not much left of the cabin, but the lamp there above the calendar. I don't know exactly what that is, but was this someone smoking in the bed? Did it go up in flames, or was it an arson attack? That's what the detectives have to find out. Just brilliant. Just fantastic. As I say, it could be arson. Could be just an accident. Not really sure. Let me know if you do know. Okay, here we have an interior. Looks to be like a farmhouse. We can see a type of barn attached to the house. They have that here in Switzerland too. With the firewood stacked up there, and in the living room there with the is that a potbelly stove there in the center? And to the right we can see a man lying on the couch, deceased. And here we see his dog has got hold of his cardigan there. There appears to be a bottle on the ground next to the couch. Was the guy drinking? Did he drink himself to death? Did he just die of natural causes? And is the dog just about to eat the corpse because he's getting hungry? I don't really know what has happened here. It doesn't seem to be any signs of injury to the man. It just looks to be, everything seems to be a bit grotty, doesn't it? Maybe the guy's wife had left him, or maybe he didn't have a wife, living alone, just didn't really look after himself, and has died. I don't know. You let me know if you know, because I don't know. But the dog is cute. His rear leg appears to be missing. That's obviously, over the years, has broken off, unfortunately. But very interesting and very well done, nevertheless. Okay, here we have a rather sweet little bathroom scene here. 50s in style, I would say. Looks very cute, which belies actually what has happened here. Murder, most foul, my viewers. Well, I think it's murder. We will now have a look. You can just see there to the right of the bathtub, there's a stool, and just behind the stool is the victim lying on the floor. Let's take a closer look. And here we have the victim here lying on the floor in her bathrobe or dressing gown, and she has a ligature around her neck. She has obviously been strangled. Or did she hang herself? The rope looks very small. Doesn't seem to be. She could have jumped off the stool. This could be a suicide. Immediately you would look at it, well, at least I did, and I thought she had been murdered, possibly. She has. It looks to be like she has been strangled. And the discoloration of the face with due to the blood. But, as I say, the stool was right next to the bathtub. Did she jump off the stool to hang herself, and the rope has snapped and she's landed on the floor? Anyway, on to the next scene. Okay, the next series of slides are just one image scenes. I couldn't find any other images related to it. And with this one, I have no idea what's going on there. Can you help me out here? Seems to be a lot of chairs and little side tables stacked up. Is that a suicide setup? Yeah, give me some clues, because I am clueless at the moment with this scene. Okay, here we have another seemingly random scene. Yeah, the lady is lying on the floor. She is obviously, well, it looks obvious to me that she has fallen off the balcony. Was she tending to her little plant pot there, and it has broken away, and she has toppled over with the momentum? Yeah, not sure what's happening there. Why is the other lady up there? What's she doing? Did she push her? Don't know what's going on there. But yeah, she seems to be lifeless. That's all I can say about this scene. I don't know anything about it. So let's go on to the next one. Yes, this diorama is another murder scene. You know, because Frances Glessner used these little dolls as the victims, in some of the scenes, it's quite hard to decide whether it's a child or an adult. But in this particular diorama, the victim is most certainly a child. It's a baby in a crib. Very horrible and distressing. So for obvious reasons, I'm not including it here. I thought I'd include the kitchen scene nonetheless, because just great diorama. Fantastic work by Frances Glessner. The door on the right is where the poor victim is, and the door on the left is going to be the next scene. It's off the dressing table, and you can see just the amount of detail that she put into her pieces. Just fantastic. Okay, here we have another one image scene of the diorama. This appears to be it's a guy who's hung himself, or has been hung, in quite a novel way, using the winch. Yeah, not too much to add to this. Don't know anything about it, but very well done, nevertheless. On to the next. And yet another single image scene. Here we have a double garage, and wow, I would love a garage and workshop like that, with an old-timer car in there. Fantastic. Yeah, so I don't know if you can see there, but in the car, slumped over the seat is the body of a man. Now, doesn't appear to have been carbon monoxide poisoning, because the doors are open. So what has happened there? How did he die? The lights are on. Was he working in there? There appears to be, on the snow, just outside the garage door there, is that the heat from the exhaust? Has it melted the snow? Did he just drive in and die of a heart attack? Or, as I say, there's no evidence of death by hose, because the doors would be shut. Give me some clues. Anybody out there that knows what's happened here? I would love to know what happened in this reenactment. Okay, on to the next. Yes, this is quite a curious scene. The victim, I think it's female, but I'm not really sure. I had a close-up of the head. The hair looks long. Probably a female. That might be blood on her face, or it could be a shadow of the hair strands. Not really sure. It looks to be like a cheap hotel room or a boarding house. Carpets are threadbare. The bed linen looks a bit scruffy, doesn't it? Yeah, looks like he or she is down on their luck. Don't know really what has happened here at all. The calendar says December 1944. I'm sure there were some significant events happened then. If anybody knows what this is about and can shed any light upon it, then I would be very happy to know. Yeah, did she die of malnutrition? Or there doesn't seem to be any evidence of violence committed upon the victim, so it's hard to work out what happened here. Well, this scene here, it's either in a cabin or a workshop. The victim appears to be a middle-aged or elderly man. lying on the floor with a gun beside him, which would initially suggest suicide. But then you see the packet of cigarettes next to the gun and also a cigarette lying near the victim's head. So do suicide victims usually have a ciggy before they pull the trigger? I don't know. You tell me. Also, the hat is lying on the floor there, sort of askew. Would the victim not place the hat carefully down? There seems to be, I don't know. Would I be orderly if I was going to kill myself? I don't know. Would I just throw my hat off? Or has he been murdered? Was he shot and his hat has flew off, landed on the floor, and the murderer has left the gun there to make it look like a suicide? But also the oven door is open. Was evidence burned there? Questions. Yeah, that's also a very tricky one. Must have been a bit of a puzzle for these detectives to put together, because I really don't know. It could be a murder or suicide. Yeah. Anyway, I leave that to you to decide, my dear viewers. Yes, this last image is not a murder scene. It's a detail of one of her dioramas for a murder scene or suicide. And I just include it because of the detail that Frances Glessner put into each and every one of her dioramas. Just that real loving detail. And you can tell from my videos that I'm also a lover of detail. And so this really appeals to me. I mean, that's all done by hand. It's just really, really mind-blowing. And I thought I would leave that with you. I'm not going to have a ramble, blah, blah, at the end of this video. I think I've rambled on enough through the whole video. But I will include in this video the comments I made about subscriber notifications that I put in the last video, which was a remake. So possibly some of the regulars have not watched the remake because they've already seen the silent version. So I will include that here. And yeah, I just wish you all a very, very lovely day or night, wherever you are, and hope you enjoyed this, something different. Take care, my friends. Yes, I would just like to address a problem that I've not only been hearing about from my viewers, but also other creators have mentioned this quite a few times. It's not a new problem, it's been around for a while, and that is to do with subscribing and subscriptions. It appears that there's some glitch where if you subscribe to a channel, you may find yourself unsubscribed and you don't even know it. So you're wondering why you're not getting notifications of new uploads. It's because you're no longer subscribed, or your subscription notification settings have been changed unbeknownst to you. So yeah, just for anyone who doesn't know about subscribing, I'm going to use as an example Madeline Swan's channel. Hello, Maddie. How are you? Thank you for letting me use your channel as an example. And please go and check Madeline's channel out. She has some fun stuff happening over there. Tells some great stories. And so as you can see here, I'm going to just unsubscribe Madeline. Please excuse me. It won't be for long. Just so I can show my viewers how this is done. And then I will resubscribe. So once we subscribe, you can see to the right of that, you will see a bell symbol. So if you want to be notified about any new uploads I do, you have to click on that bell symbol and then check the box, send notifications. And then you will receive notifications when I make a new upload, when I post a new upload. And I would advise all of my viewers just to check to see if they're still subscribed to me. As I say, this is a problem. YouTube is aware of this. I actually wrote to them about half a year ago about this, and they said they are aware of the problem and they're working on it, but it still seems to be happening. And also, any subscribers who are still subscribed, just check your notification settings to make sure that you're still checked to get notifications, all of them. Yes, I had a few comments from my viewers over the last few days saying that they hadn't received notification of any new uploads, and they'd just come along to my channel to see whether I had any new uploads, and there they had realized that they weren't being notified and that some of them were actually unsubscribed. They hadn't done it, it just happened. So please, YouTube, please get your act together. You're making it difficult. Yes, we shall just soldier on, my dear Oddites. We shall soldier on in the face of adversity.